Hello? How are you guys? Hello? Thank you, you are awesome too. Hey! Hi. Wow, we got a real contest here. How are you guys? Good to see you, Happy New Year. Good. First of all, congratulations for winning the contest. That's what you get. Come here. We talk a little bit about math. Got a little contest here. Have fun, relaxed, and enjoy it. How many of you really like math? Teachers don't count today. It's just between you and me, the truth. You really like math? Who really don't like it? Some honesty, that's good. Okay, all right. In my case, I really like math. I think it's very useful. I use it every single day, playing basketball too. Before every game, we get stats with percentages, with the amount of shots that our opponents take, the amounts we take, what are the better odds for making a shot, and what is not so, you know, if we start taking half-court shots every time, probabilities are not going to be that good. So that's a way of, you know, doing math too.
Like a one-on-one competition. So we're going to get two people up here. Manu's going to hold up a problem for you. You have a whiteboard here that you can work it out on. The first one to get it, when you think you've got the answer, ring the bell. The first one with it right, that will be the winner's side. Somebody will just get lucky and get to start over there. So if you get it right, you stay there. You get it wrong, you go back, and somebody new comes up to challenge, okay? You understand?
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's start with you two guys right here.
Good job, I can see it. 45. So now how do we proceed? He moves here? Good job, good job. He got to the final answer too, a little slower. Remember, in this case, the fastest is, you know, is winning. But it doesn't mean that it's or smarter or more intelligent or nothing like that. It just happened to be faster.
If they can do it without writing the problem out, they can just write the answer, right? Yeah,
right?
Yes.
Of course. Whenever you think you got the answer, boom, and say it. Now I gotta show it because you got some. You ready? Okay. 12 divided by 4 plus 7 per 3. Say what? 24, 3 plus. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Didn't need to write it. Good job. Got a good one here. Here's the answer. Jesse, you didn't believe me. You ready to write? We got 7,231 plus 988. Good job, sir. Okay, but you guys, do we all fit? Okay, say cheese.
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 Go Spurs, go.
1, 2, 3.
Go
Spurs, go.
Go
Spurs, go. Yep.
This time we're all the way out in Kemper. What brings you out this way?
Well, they were the school that was chosen, the won the contest. So I was happy to come to Comfort and meet these kids. I mean, it was fun. I could have stayed longer. It was too short after the riddles, but I hope they enjoyed it and they learned a little bit at least.
Well, we played a different game this year as opposed to last year shooting the basket.
Yes, we played a different game. It was more about how fast you are answering. But you gotta be accurate too. And then I bring a couple of riddles that I really enjoy before. And well, as I said before, hopefully they had fun. I did.
Now, a lot of those kids, or a couple of them, stayed up there for a long time. What did you think, seeing some of those kids who were really good?
Well, there were a couple of kids that, you know, some have just, it's easier for them. Some others, that doesn't mean, as I said before to them, that they are smarter or just more intelligent. They just happen to be quick and they pick it up easier. But you just gotta cheer the other guys too, because the challenge is on getting the answer, not always faster, but get the right one. So it was important to come here and spend some time with them too.
Why do you pick to push math on the students?
Because I think that math is somehow underrated in school. A lot of kids don't like it. They feel intimidated by numbers. And I feel it's so exciting and amusing, and I love doing like riddles or playing with numbers, and I always liked it. So I try to share my enthusiasm, and you can have fun with it too. So I think it was a nice situation.
Anything else about those kids that really shocked you today?
No, that they were really into it. They were all trying to give answers. They were good with the numbers. So it's good to see that. I mean, it's easy to find excitement around basketball, soccer, or baseball, but around math, it's not that easy. So it's good that they can enjoy it too.
Is it easy for you to translate the use of math in basketball with what you do to what they are learning?
Well, we have math all the time in basketball, with percentages and probabilities and the record, the standings. It's something that we really use very often. So, but even outside sports, it's something that you live with it every day. When you go to a store, when you walk, when you start thinking, how long did I walk or how long it took. So it's something that is good to be good at.
It was great to get out and expand our reach. We've expanded our program just over the last 2 years to farther out, to kind of get where everybody who is our fans at and as far as we can go and help the kids. And so it's great to be able to actually get them this far. Some days, you know, it's hard to get them across San Antonio, so it's nice to be able to get them out this
now,
way.
With this program, the Math Minutes, Manu's Math Minutes, how did he get selected to be part of it?
Manu actually came and asked us. He wanted a program. And we said, we will do our best to help you. And we asked him what he liked, and he loved math. And he said, I'd love to have a math program. We didn't have a math program at that time. So last year we sat down and we developed this program just for him.
All right. Find this program, and how did you get involved? How many years have you been doing it?
Well, this was our first year to do the Manu Minute. And our math department head, Ms. Fabness, she told us about it, and she gave us all of the handouts because it's 15 little quizzes. And I looked at it and I thought, gee, this is going to be tough for sixth grade because it's geared for middle school math. And our principal, Mr. Yeske, said, well, I want all of the math classes in Comfort participating. I think it'll be good for them. So we did it for the first, I guess, for 3 weeks up till December 5th. We did the Manu Minute as a warm-up. And I tell the kids, well, if you don't know, they said, well, we haven't done percents yet. And I said, it's okay. It's all right. Just put a question mark. Just keep trying. That's all I ask for you to do. And so we were told that they could enter, you know, just for trying and working hard, and we got lucky.